Our person of the week, a man who changed your life by creating Amazon. He also made big news this week when he decided to buy the venerable Washington Post newspaper for $250 million. So what is Jeff Bezos up to this time, this wildly creative man who refuses to become a grown-up if growing up means losing curiosity and joy?
Listen, it's a famous sound when Jeff Bezos gets to learn something new. He laughs.
That was awesome!
It's his sense of wonder that something great is always over the horizon.
I'm a big believer!
After all, he created that little cart that turned Amazon into the world's largest online retailer. Even though a lot of people believed he could never deliver on the promise.
1998, Amazon.toast. And 1999, Amazon.bomb. My mom hates this picture.
Bezos says he'd like everyone to treat failure as part of their journey of discovery.
If you want to invent, if you want to do any innovation, anything new, you're going to have failures because you need to experiment.
He started experimenting as a three-year-old child, so curious he dismantled his own crib with a screwdriver. And then there were all those worrying inventions at home.
I was constantly booby-trapping the house with various kinds of alarms. And, you know, some of them were not just, you know, audible sounds, but actually, like, you know, physical booby traps. I think I occasionally worried my parents that they were going to open the door one day and, you know, have 30 pounds of nails drop on their head or something.
But it wasn't necessarily the conventional story leading to success. He doesn't know his biological father, who left when he was just 1 year old. His teenage mother married an immigrant from Cuba named Mike Bezos, who adopted the quirky kid, who started Amazon by selling books and shipping them out of his own garage. Today, he is selling up to 200 items per second. One of his warehouses the size of 28 football fields.
We love to invent.
So everyone is watching this week to see what Jeff Bezos will do with the Washington Post. Don't bet against him. After all, this is a man who invested in a 200-foot-tall clock to be put inside a mountain in Texas. It will chime once a century, a kind of hello to the infinite future from a guy who loves the infinite possibilities right now.
We love to pioneer. We even like going down alleys that turn out to be blind alleys. Of course, every once in a while, one of those blind alleys opens up into a broad avenue.
And so we choose the astonishing Jeff Bezos.